Hello, hello, hello. Assalamu alaikum. Ji ayanu, pakhair ragale, ni hao, chunashume, washmale, ohayo gonzaimus, guten morgen, hola, bonjour, privyet, kaifahal, halashama chatore, ahlan wasalan marhaba, mucho, gracias, ishpata, buna, and a very amazing good morning to everybody who's tuned into PTV World and are watching World This Morning on a Tuesday, where it's raining outside over here in Islamabad. Ladies and gentlemen, the weather over here is superb, fantastic, and fantabulous. To go outside, but with me, I have the under the weather, Shiza Hashmi. Hello, Shiza, how are you today?
I'm doing absolutely great. How are you? And how was your long, long weekend?
Well, it wasn't really a weekend, you know, so my life is certainly just like yours as well, because you work on weekends too, and I think that I'm very obliged to Allah me over here for giving me so much and, you know, different types of work which I get to do, and people get to know us too as well. So I was in Multan, one of the gigantic festivals, ladies and gentlemen, is taking place all over Pakistan as well, which is why we're even coming to Islamabad on the 25th, 26th and 27th. So lock your dates too as well.
I've been waiting for this for like more than 2 months now. I can't wait.
Because we had to postpone it because of rain, and everybody knows that too as well. But this time we are like, whether it's raining or not, but we are still coming to Islamabad as well. But other than that,
speaking of rain, was it raining in Multan as well?
Oh, you know, you cannot even imagine how difficult it was to travel to Multan and then come back, because there were no flights and and you know, no other medium of transportation was available. So ladies and gentlemen, it was not just raining in Multan. So earlier it was raining in Islamabad, then it was raining in Lahore, and then it was raining in Sahiwal, and then it was raining in Multan too as well, and that was the same case on my way back. But which is why we wanted to give you a weather update. And intermittent rain continues in most parts of the country, while heavy snowfall is recorded in upper areas including Hazara, Malakand, Gilgit-Baltistan and Azad Kashmir.
Well, heavy snowfall has plunged temperatures below freezing point. Met Office has predicted more rain and snowfall.
More widespread rain is expected in Malakand, Hazara, Mardan, Kohat, Rawalpindi, Gujranwala, Lahore, Islamabad, Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan, while at scattered places in Peshawar, Sargodha and Faisalabad divisions. But not just that, ladies and gentlemen, few moderate to heavy falls are also expected in Malakand, Hazara, Rawalpindi, Gujranwala divisions, Islamabad and Kashmir. And alongside those lines, more snowfall over hills is also expected. So please make sure that if you're roaming around within the perimeters of these cities, to keep an umbrella in your car. And if you want to go up north or probably into the hills, make sure that you take along quite a lot of jackets, sweaters and whatnot, gloves, probably mufflers, to keep yourself warm, because it might probably give you a little bit of snowfall and might give you a little bit of trouble if you're not wearing some proper clothing, just like Shiza didn't over the weekend, I guess.
I think, yes, that's what happened.
Yes, that's what it is.
So whose birthday are we celebrating today?
All right, so today, you know, we have a surprise for all those people who are out there. And I'm calling it a surprise, ladies and gentlemen, because the lady we've been joined by today, she's over here in our studios. It's her birthday. It's her very special day as well. And we wanted it to be special because of the fact that for the last 60 years...
More than 60.
More than 60 years, she made us smile. You know, she made us learn about all of those things which we never knew. She gave us knowledge. She imparted knowledge. She disseminated information. And she made our days and mornings so beautiful that we love her. And we're still going to continue to love her too as well. And the best part is that we have moved the birthday segment towards the end, because we want our bosses and everybody to join us. We're going to have a cake over here. And today's birthday wish is actually going to be from the studio alongside the lady whose birthday it is.
But before we introduce her, I think we have to take a look at a package over here.
Yes.
That our team made about Radio Pakistan. So I think let's take a look at it.
Let's do that.
Pakistan Broadcasting Service. Hum Lahore se bol rahe hain. 13 और 14 अगस्त सन 47 ईस्वी की दरमियानी रात 12 बजे हैं.
As radio in Lahore grew in significance as the sole medium through which listeners could be instantly reached, two women stand out for their brilliance. They were Mohini Hamid and Satna Mehmood Kaur. About Mohini Hamid, the thrill of her voice, the pauses, the silences, she knew how to keep millions glued to her story. For 39 long years, listeners in Pakistan listened to her voice. Just as Mohini Hamid was Pakistan's first woman broadcaster, her daughter Kanwal Naseer became Pakistan's first woman telecaster. Kanwal Naseer has also completed 50 years in radio and television. Today, with changing trends, we have major radio transmissions featuring female RJs. Some famous names are RJ Ghazal, RJ Nigat Qureshi, RJ Riz, and many more. These RJs are widely being followed on social media and listened with keen interest across Pakistan.
Yeah, and it definitely takes me back in time too, ladies and gentlemen. I think my team actually forgot about putting me into that list too as well.
Right, you were radio jockey before you, you know, ventured into TV.
Exactly, and I think I've loved every bit of being into, working for a radio station too, ladies and gentlemen. I think that the timing and the quality of your voice improves a lot. And then, you know, because you have to actually work it with the hands of the clock and then the BG or the background music which is working, so it is really a creative process. Yeah. And even if we go back in time, I wanted to talk about Agha Nasir Saab. You know, I think he was one of the very legendary figures. Unfortunately, he's not with us anymore, but he's been on the show, and I think that's a privilege. You know, he was the first one to actually own a radio in Pakistan as well.
Wow.
So, and you know, he used to tell us that there used to be plays on radio, ladies and gentlemen, where, you know, we could actually feel as if the train's approaching onto the platform.
Wow.
You know, there are people talking. So radio, I think, has transformed a lot, but radio originally over here within Pakistan has transformed the lives of a lot of people. For example, people who worked for radio and people who used to listen to those stations too as well.
Absolutely.
Which is why, ladies and gentlemen, that today on her birthday, we wanted her to be a part of our show as well. You know, as we have earlier discussed as well, she is daughter to Miss Mohini as well, which was definitely one of the very first voices on Radio Pakistan or the broadcasting service, as we used to call it then. But then other than that, you know, she was the first one who actually came up on Pakistan television and said that, you know, this is Pakistan television. Ladies and gentlemen, she's a legend. And we are very glad that she's over here with us today on her birthday, on her special day. She's none other than Miss Kanwal Naseer. Hello, assalamu alaikum, how are you?
Wa alaikum assalam. You've made me nostalgic, you've honored me on my birthday, and thank you so much for saying all those nice things.
Thank you very much.
But looking at radio, it really gives me, I can still shiver watching these people, you know, it gives me shivers to think that I was blessed to be with them.
Alhamdulillah.
And part of Radio Pakistan. And I think to my dying day, I will be part of television, of course. That's the basic thing.
Exactly.
I did, but radio is was my home.
Radio is life.
Radio is life.
Amazing that.
So, ma'am, you were 7 years of age when you started radio. Was it accidental? Was it planned? Tell us all about it.
Nishaza, it wasn't planned. Hmm. It was accidental in the sense that we used to go, because everything was live and because live transmission 24/7. So I used to go with my mother, because as you heard, she used to tell the story every evening, and on Sunday do the children's program, and she was the topmost drama artist of the country, because after partition, the main actors that were there in Lahore on what would then have been All India Radio Lahore had left, which had big names like Kamini Kaushal and Chetan Anand and Om Prakash and Shamshad Begum and, you know, so everything, my mother says, everything was new.
Okay.
And of course, these people were there, and we would go for the children's program. And one day, one of the little boys who was supposed to, there always used to be a little skit, because it was a 1 hour program for about 15 minutes. Shazade Shazadiyon ki kahani, of course, you know, it was very simple and innocent. And so that kid didn't come, and my voice was a little husky. So they said, you do this boy's role in just 5 minutes, kind of thing. I didn't know how to read Urdu.
Wow.
Because I was in a convent and I never had studied. So they made me memorize it quickly, you know, whatever it was. And I said that. And that was the day, and then I never got back home.
Wow.
Wow. It's an inspiring story, of course.
Yeah.
But, you know, things were different back then as well. We were talking before the show, and you mentioned that the mics were not portable. And, you know, the studios and everything, they were different. You have seen a change, like, over so many years.
Yeah.
How do you feel that with TV, especially PTV, and with Radio Pakistan as well, the change has been? Is it good? Is it bad? Are we going in the right direction with this?
Or probably, you know, I think that the question needs to be like this, that have you ever seen, have you seen changing Or have you seen that, you know, things have changed over time within these institutions?
Right.
Now, a lot of people are not going to like this, I'm
sure.
Yeah,
I think so.
I'm not being harsh or anything, but having come from the age of 6 and 7 and to grow up to 70 with these two institutions, yes. Radio was a university.
Yeah.
Radio was where you went and you got your stresses and pauses and your breathing and your everything right, you know. And everything you said was expressed through your voice because there was, of course, no video to it. So there was hard work because you had to do a lot of rehearsals.
Yeah.
Now the changes, as you say, at when I started as a child and when I even saw, like you saw Rafi Peer and my mother over there and big names, you know, the producer was the key person, you know. Everybody listened to the producer. Moinimi didn't say, I'm a star, I'm not, or, you know, Peer Saab didn't say. The producer, because the producers were so well-versed with drama, I mean, they were well-read, extremely well-read, and knew their jobs. Like Izhar Kazmi, if he knew about drama, then he also knew who Ernest Hemingway was, and he also knew who Bernard Shaw was. That kind of well-educated, that right, well-read people who knew about. Or when Salim Gilani Saab came, he knew about music. And I think the difference is that they kept learning and then giving their artist their know-how and their knowledge, you know, like intangible heritage that we carried around. So were the music producers, the biggest names in, later on in Pakistan television and in the film industry in this country came from the Radio Pakistan.
Yeah. Wow, that's beautiful.
Exactly, that is beautiful. But then, you know, I think that the question stays the same as well, you know, because we have been very unable to answer the question which we probably posed to her, ladies and gentlemen. And we do not even want it to be difficult for you to answer this question. But we think that, you know, it is solely your responsibility as one of those people who've actually been the flag bearers for PTV and Radio Pakistan to highlight or to let people know that these are the areas where we can work together and be a better team in days to come.
Shehzad and Shiza, both of you, like my own children to me.
Yeah.
I've seen you grow, I've seen you, I've heard
you
on radio, and I think it does a lot of good to be on radio because, all, like I said, you learn a lot. But it has changed with time, like look at the plays that were there, look at the playwrights. It's not as if there is a dearth of talent now.
Okay.
It's just that the producer at that time went and searched, went and looked.
Yeah.
And the same goes for television. Like Iftikhar Arif Saab, he says, I came and I spoke to Aslam and he said, tomorrow can you be on air?
Yeah.
You know, same way Gilani Saab goes and he listens to a lady who's singing like Reshma and he gives her a card and 100 rupees to get to Lahore and she becomes Reshma.
Wow.
Yeah.
Tufail Niazi, Aslam Saab brought that. So many names that I can tell you. Fazal Kamal Saab brought me to television, you know.
Yeah.
I'm not a star, but I mean, they when they saw that this person has potential, they helped out and were there, stood behind us, taught us. Aga Saab, I mean, it was so dear to me, the family is so dear to me. But these were people that built their relationships with us with love and understanding and helped us and taught us and told us. We are in a, like when we were growing up, we were told, look what all they left behind to come to make Pakistan. So we have to put in our bit.
Exactly.
Right, right, absolutely. I
think that this is how you actually put it out there for people too as well. You know, this was one a very amazing way to make people understand that, you know, these are the things which we really need to work on. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, I think there's one fact, and that is that there's one thing which never changed, and I think that that's Miss Kanwal Naseer Saab herself, Saiba herself too as well, which is why we are actually going to make you nostalgic about the very fact that how she used to be on the shows earlier and how she is. She still looks the same, I think.
Absolutely.
And it makes me feel as if, you know, I am probably 15 years old right now, today, you know, while I'm actually looking at her. So we've got one small clip. It is obviously in honor of Miss Kanwal Naseer, ladies and gentlemen. So let's go ahead, and this is from 19th of January with Mr. Tausik Heather. So go ahead and please take a look.
लंबा सा सफर है क्या ये वाकई लगता है लंबा था या लगता है पलक झपकते में गुजर गया
खासा लंबा है लेकिन सचमुच पलक झपकते में अब मैं जब देखती हूँ अपनी उम्र और फिर मैं देखती हूँ आप सबको बच्चे जो थे अब आप लोग इतने एंकर्स हैं बड़े बड़े तो फिर मुझे लगता है कि बहुत मुद्दत हो गई
अच्छा एक चीज मुझे बताइए कि आप की जो शख्सियत है आपके 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 चलने का अंदाज आपकी बॉडी लैंग्वेज आपकी गुफ्तगू का अंदाज द वे यू कैरी योरसेल्फ एक बहुत बाएतमाद एक बहुत ही स्ट्रॉन्ग एक बहुत ही मजबूत खातून का लेकिन एक दिन आपके घर खाने पे बैठे बैठे आपने अपने दिल की एक बात मुझे की थी और मैंने सोचा वहीं से आगाज करूं आपने कहा था तौसीक विचों में बहुत डरपोक
हां सच का बहुत मैं तो इब्तिदा में तो क्राउड को देख के मेरा आम सोशल क्राउड को देख के भी ना तो देयर समथिंग यू मुट्ठी में बंद हो जाती थी मुझे लगता था क्या ये मैं क्या करूँगी इतने सारे लोग हैं यहाँ रियली
तो ये इसका मतलब है ये फिर क्रिएट किया ये ट्रेन किया अपने आप को इस तरह से
बहादुर होना पड़ा है ना बहादुर होना पड़ा इसलिए कि इब्तिदा आप देखिए ना तो एक लड़की और 24 मर्द जिसमें सिर्फ 17 तो जापानीज थे
All right, the which I'm very scared. I'm very scared within my own self as well. So this is one statement which I wanted to be out there for somebody who's been on radio, for somebody who's been on television for so long. How can she be scared of 24 men around her?
That was a different age, but Zia Muhyiddin Saab said to me, he used to be in plays with my mother when he was in Government College Lahore. So I said to him when they asked me to do Pakistan National Council of the Arts, strangely enough, Deja Vu, Khalid Said Bhatt said, you can do it. Yeah. And I said, no, I can't go on stage. Television's different. Here you face an audience. And I was really scared.
Yeah.
And he said, no, you can do it. Okay. We went there, and so I spoke to Zia. Zia Saab is very dear to me. And I said, "Ke Zia Saab, I'm very, very scared to do this." And he said to me that, Kamal, the first 5 seconds when I walk on stage, even I'm nervous. I said, you are nervous?
Yeah.
So then I, you know, that gave me a lot of impetus. If he can get nervous, main bichari kaun hoon.
And then you moved on with that.
So I said, okay, that's
it. But I think when you're doing live with radio and TV as well, being nervous is totally normal. But what I want you to do right now is share probably a funny story or a blunder from your life that you've never done on TV before. We should be the first one to
because
hear
if
it.
It's a blunder, you know, you never want it to be on television.
No, but it should be a funny story. We're just sharing stories.
Yeah, funny,
from television, right. From television, in the beginning, you see, we just had this glass in between and the studio was right across. Okay. So Bilqis Khanum, she's one of the first singers who came live. Tufail Niazi Saab was there the first day, but Bilqis was there. So I'd seen her on radio while she was singing. So when she came into the studio and she didn't know now that the camera was on and I was sitting here in the announcer's booth and I said ke ab Bilqis Khanum aapko sunayengi purana geet jo hai ye wo aur I said so when she came on air she says Kamal theek ho oh god from the studio
right.
So I ducked When I ducked, I hit the table, you know, because there wasn't enough space.
Right.
So I tried to duck and Aslam would have asked me outside, why didn't you move out of the booth immediately?
Yeah.
You know,
wow.
So there used to be these things that were strange happenings. I would do a, because there were no other anchors.
Yeah.
They hadn't come in yet. Farooq Zameer Saab. Famous actor, very, very nice person. His mother used to do a cookery show live in the studio. And of course, because she spoke in English, I would tarjama karo it quickly into Urdu. And then, because we didn't have any commercials, anybody, you see, we all worked together. Aslam Saab being the GM and the MD and whatever, he'd still hold the door of the studio so that I could run from the studio and get back into the announcer's booth and then keep, hold my breath and go on for the next program.
Yeah.
So you see, we all shared, and there was those 3 hours, 6 to 9, 6 days a week. Mondays we had off. Were like electric, you know.
Yeah.
We couldn't make a mistake. We couldn't do a blunder. Tariq kehta hai na, wo yahan se seekha usne.
Exactly.
Kadati ki gunjaish nahi.
It's all one take, ladies and gentlemen, and this is what we actually believe in as well. You know, there are a lot of people who definitely make good use of technology these days. Their prompters right in front of us. But you know, just because Madam over here shared one of her stories, so I wanted to share one of my stories as well. And so, you know, obviously quite a lot of funny incidents take place, but one day, so I actually joined PTV World as a news anchor.
Right.
So thanks to Allah for giving me an opportunity to host the morning show. So one day I was reading news and all of a sudden I could see the camera moving towards the left. Na? So the camera started to lean towards the left. And the cameraman, unfortunately, was sitting. You know, he wasn't, they're supposed to stand, I mean, which they are right now as well. But that day, you know, I think it was ought to happen. So what happened was that the camera started to tilt slightly, 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 and eventually fell onto the cameraman as well.
Oh, God.
And then I was like, okay, so, you know, even if the camera fell, I think probably the audio needs to go out too as well.
So,
you know, I kept on talking, I kept on speaking. Cameraman having no idea of what actually happened to him because he never knew that the camera fell on
him.
So ladies and gentlemen, things like these do happen, and I think PTV has obviously played a role of a nursery and then as a university as well. But then at the same time, there's this one grief I have for all those people who once used to be a part of PTV. And that's something which I'll share after the break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back because we are in conversation with the legendary Miss Kanwal Naseer.
Good morning. Stay tuned.
Magla Hills, the heaven of Islamabad, the abode of God, a place where you can explore your soul and meet power of natural elegance of mountains. Spread over an area of 12,605 hectares, the Magla Range, the foothills of Himalayas, are youngest hills with an age of 5,000 years old. Magla Hills are home to around 600 plant species, 250 bird varieties, 38 mammals, and 13 species of reptiles. Magla Range is characterized by many valleys, scenic spots, and beautiful water streams, especially in the monsoon months. Famous for their tranquil environment and lush green natural splendor, Magla Hills are a particular source of pride, harmony, and spiritual solace. For the residents of Islamabad, many of whom make it a weekly ritual to scale the various trails to Damanagar and Pir Suhawa. Magla Hills send off its visitors with lasting trail of memories to relish in solitude and provide an escape from the relentless rhythm of life.
The ancient city of Taxila is the heart of stonework in Pakistan. This
Right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. For everybody who just got tuned into PTV World, you watching World This Morning alongside Chiza Hashmi and Shahzad Khan. Today, ladies and gentlemen, is a great day because of the fact that we've actually been joined by the very legendary Miss Kanwal Naseer as well, because she was the first one to be on Pakistan television. Right. And then she definitely comes from a family where, you know, they're born artists. And, you know, she's been working for radio and television for more than 60 years. You know, it is our pleasure. And then I think it is in terms an honor for all of us to have actually been privileged by her presence. But right now, before moving towards the break, as I mentioned, that there are a lot of actors fraternity, which I think really need to give back to the community they have worked with. For example, a lot of news anchors, a lot of people who are actually journalists, a lot of people who are actors, drama producers and whatnot, once they were a part of Pakistan television. And I know that for sure for all those people on all of these other channels, they were once a part of Pakistan television. And now, you know, the most unfortunate moment for all of us is that we tend to call them on our shows. What they do say is, are you paying us? So imagine what PTV did for you, that it made you a career, it made you a fortune. You know, you sent your children to school. You had each and every facility any privileged human being might even have. And then at the same time, you refuse to come to the same organization who taught you what you are to today. So this is one grief. I wanted it to be out there as well. But right now, alongside Ms. Kanwal Naseer, ladies and gentlemen, we have been joined by people who are actually following her footsteps as well. She's one of the very most heard RJ, well-versed RJ as well on radio this time around. And whenever I text her, probably if I listen to her on radio, she's definitely going to give a shout out and will ask for a song if you need to play one. She's none other than Miss Nighat. Hello, assalamu alaikum, how are you?
Shahzad. Hello, Shiza, how are you?
Absolutely perfect. Thank you very much for joining us. And how does it feel to be sitting right next to Miss Kanwal Naseer?
Yeah, I am so honored to be here because she is one of the legendary artists sitting here. And I think I'm no one in front of her.
All right. So I think everybody feels like this room right now. But ladies and gentlemen, we have also been joined by our lifestyle coach who actually comes up with so many different ideas and dishes and whatnot and alternatives to keep you healthy. She's none other than Miss Lubna Khan Faraz. Hello. Hi. How are you?
I'm doing excellent and I feel amazing to be amongst everybody here.
Thank you very much. It's good to have you over here. So Nighat, I think that, you know, I'll probably ask you a few questions as before we move over to Miss Kanwal Naseer. So, you know, it's been more than 10 years that you've been affiliated with radio.
Yeah,
and then, you know, we still have a figure for whom it's more than 60 years that she's been a part of radio and television. So in these 10 years, what have you learned so far, which you can probably share with people who are out there?
Yeah, for sure. Because radio jocking is not just about talking.
Yeah.
So it's about you have a positive attitude towards whatever you are learning to, whatever you are saying, because there are so many people who are listening to you right away.
Yeah.
So first of all, you have to be very confident.
Okay.
I have learned lots of patience and then a lot of confidence because if somebody gives you a script, when you don't have confidence, you cannot even say a single thing. So I have learned a lot. And yes, in 10 years, probably it was the best thing ever happened to me when I've joined radio.
I think that's great. Yeah, but, you know, at the same time, you know, since I used to listen to radio quite a lot, I even do it right now. I think Khalid Malik is one of my favorite broadcasters too as well. Sophie Anjum, ladies and gentlemen, I think is one of my very favorite as well. But other than that, you know, what I've seen is that on radio, when a woman speaks, you know, she gets a lot of fan base, which is probably dependent on telephone, you know, so they call and then every time they're going to call, they're going to have a different perspective. So one day you're listening to a call over the radio, aap hi kaisi hain aap, then the other day, mujhe awaaz achhi lagti, then the other day, you know, that's so things actually, keep on changing.
Yeah, it is.
You know, but this is something which never happened to me while I was on radio. Nobody told me that, you know, bhai, awaaz achhi lagti hai mujhe. But you know, why not? So what's the difference?
That's actually vice versa, because once a female is doing a show, she'll probably get lots of callers, male yeah. callers, in fact. And once the male is doing a show, he'll get lots of female audience for sure.
Yeah.
So that's absolutely a vice versa. And yes, people loves to listen to the radio RJs,
yeah.
and because TV is slightly a bit different thing. But okay. you have to play with your voice.
Exactly.
And you have to entertain with your voice. So I think I'm
yeah,
blessed
to have.
One last
question before we move
yeah.
on to Miss Kamal over here. So
sure.
you know, we've asked her this question too as well. What is the most awkward thing people would say when they'll call you on your show and you're actually on air? What is the most awkward thing people have said it so far, which you can say on air today? Because we're a morning show and we're a family show, okay? So yeah, most awkward thing somebody has ever said to you.
Once there was a lady and she said, "Okay, I just want to be."
Okay, she's thinking whether to say it or not. Come on.
Yeah, exactly. I'm just thinking out. Okay,
yeah.
Rather, so, I should say or
but
not.
Did she propose you?
Yeah, she did.
So she proposed to she, ladies and gentlemen. That was the most weirdest thing, which actually.
I was like, what should I say now? Okay, thank you.
Okay, but you would have said. I don't know what, but so ma'am, you know, things like these do happen.
Oh, yes.
You know, people have a lot of different ways in letting you know that how much they love you. So any crazy fan mail you ever got?
Oh, the craziest one.
Written with blood or something.
Oh,
like that.
Okay. We had right in the beginning when everything was live. But before I tell you the story, I must give
sure.
them credit because they never went through any training of any kind.
Yeah.
We got trained by listening to the big icons,
exactly.
you know.
Yeah.
So they and so I think they're very brave
yeah.
to take them because microphone is also a very it's a big responsibility because every word you say goes
exactly.
across
exactly.
and you can't
it
take
is.
It back. It's
exactly.
not a recording and it's not so that having said that, in the beginning. They used to keep four, there used to be this four and a coin,
yeah.
which was very expensive because in those days, you can imagine four and mattered.
Yeah.
So sometimes all the news, everything was in one room. They would keep these four and a coins and they'd said, as soon as we stopped, either Tariq or myself came out of, whenever the phone rang,
yeah.
they would put a bet for Tariq or for Kamal. For Tariq or for Kamal, you know, and by the end of the day, of the evening, they had collected quite a bit of money
yeah.
with which they used to get rasmalai
wow.
from Eden Road, and they would all eat that. So we would get strange kind of proposals, of course, I mean, all kinds of things, and people saying,
oh, it is hilarious.
Oh, God, it was a. Really, really strange.
Yeah. And it's good to think about those times too as well. But there's one thing, ladies and gentlemen, which never changed, and that's how she actually looks even today. And I think
I know that
she's definitely, you know, aged very gracefully as well. And a lot of women out there and people actually follow her for the type of style, you know,
right.
which is not very conventional though. But I think that she made sure that, you know, she stays intact with the cultural values we had and the norms we had. And staying fit, ladies and gentlemen, is very important, which is why we have Lubna Khan Faraz over here in the studios with us, talking about
anti-aging foods.
Yes, anti-aging food. I don't know. I think that she's actually going to talk about avocado today.
Or
I think avocado is overrated. Well, but let's see. Go
so
ahead.
You have a problem with avocados. I'm going to make you avocado toast one day.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to be talking about anti-aging foods, but I want everyone to remember that anti-aging foods are not just foods that are going to help you anti-age or reverse aging or help slow down the process of aging. What they also do is help you with heart disease, help you with any chronic diseases, cardiovascular diseases that we have today, skin diseases, skin protection, all of that together. So the first one that I want to talk about today is definitely blueberries. So blueberries are the king of berries, but mind you, if you can't find blueberries, you can have strawberries, raspberries, and everything like that. So blueberries are amazing. They have amazing antioxidants in them. And when you're thinking about skin, you want to go towards antioxidants and healthy fats. So because that's what helps your collagen, and collagen is like the glue that helps your skin stay more firm and more plump. So blueberries are definitely number one for me. The number two thing that's my favorite, and I'm sure everybody loves, is dark chocolate. Yeah. So this by means, I don't mean to have a go and have a big bar of dark chocolate, but you can definitely have it in moderation. And again, it's full of antioxidants in there as well. And the properties that are in dark chocolate, many studies have shown that if you already have a healthy diet and you add dark chocolate, it can definitely have amazing effects on your skin as well.
Okay.
The next one that I have here is figs. So figs are found very easily in Pakistan, and you can have dried figs or fresh figs as well. And they are full of antioxidants as well, and especially in the skin of the fig. So that's where the antioxidants mostly lie. And that pink color that's in the actual fresh fig, they are excellent. So the seeds in there, the skin of the fig is excellent for your skin as well. The next one that I want to talk about are nuts, and more specifically chestnuts, pecans, and walnuts that are excellent for skin as well. So you definitely want to get those healthy fats in your diet, put them on your salad, have them as a snack, whatever you can do. The next one that I have here is salmon or fish. So salmon, I say because of the antioxidants that are in there as well. That pink color that you see in salmon, that is so beneficial for your skin. And a lot of supplements that we find in collagen and all of that, they already have those compounds in there. So why not intake the actual food and enjoy the taste of it as well? The next one that I have is my absolute favorite, is bone broth. And bone broth is gaining a lot of hype in the fitness industry, and for very, very good reasons. Super easy to make at home. You can make it with vegetables, chicken, a beef, whatever you like. And it's very important to make sure you get all the nice fatty acids in there, add in some herbs, make it taste amazing. So herbs, I'm going to be mentioning turmeric as well. You can add in whatever you like and make it super beneficial. And collagen, whenever you go to the dermatologist, they tell you, oh, do a PRP or inject collagen in your skin. So why not intake the actual collagen from the food source in itself? So have some bone broth today. And the next one that I'm going to be saying, Shahzad has a problem with. So avocados. Avocados are actually great, which is why they're being used in so many face masks. And because they have polyunsaturated fats and monounsaturated fats as well. So those healthy fats are excellent for your skin, hair, nails, everything. So an avocado a day, Shahzad, will keep the dermatologist away, okay? So try
having it. Well, if the dermatologist is my sister, I do not want to keep away.
Okay, all right. So yes, if you don't want to go under the knife, have the avocados.
Yeah. Wow. Okay, that's great. Wow. Thank you very much for, shedding light onto some different flavors which we can have while being healthy too as well. But with that, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go head out towards a short break because it's Miss Kanwal Naseer's birthday and I can't keep calm. Let's take a break.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is Shahzad with a big piece of chocolate in his mouth. And he's lighting the candles right now because we are about to celebrate the long-awaited birthday.
Okay, so let's start up. Ladies and gentlemen, it's one of our very legendaries, Ms. Kanwal Naseer's birthday, and one of our producers from World This Morning.
Vikas Bangar,
we can have you over here within. Yeah. All right, so ma'am, I'm sorry,
please, but
you know, they went off, but let's do it. Because you want to join her?
Okay.
Happy birthday to you. May you have many more. Happy birthday, Miss Kanwal Naseer and Vikas Bangar. May you have many more. Thank you very much, ma'am. And probably, I think that I'm going to give you this chocolate. Yeah. All right. It's all right. It's all right. Let's pick it up. Ladies and gentlemen, do write to us on our Facebook page, which is with the name of World This Morning. Mr. Jamshed just joined us as well. He's one of our producers too. For Facebook, it is?
It's World This Morning.
For Twitter?
World This Morning without Jamshed.
For Dailymotion and YouTube.
World This Morning.
And this fabulous recipe is going to be at
5 past 11 p.m.
Till the next time, 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday! Good morning.